En el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo. The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of our Lord's Paschal mystery, that is to say, of his passion and resurrection. For it was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city of our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ, the King in exaltation, may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please raise up your palms. We're going to bless them with holy water.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. When Jesus and his disciples drew near to Jerusalem, to Bethphage and to Bethany, at the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village opposite you, and immediately on entering it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone should say to you, 'Why are you doing this?' reply, 'The master has need of it and will send it back here at once.' So they went off and found a colt tethered at the gate outside the street, and they untied it. Some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They answered them just as Jesus had told them to, and they permitted them to do it. So they brought the colt to Jesus and put their coats over it. And he sat on it. Many people spread their coats on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut from the fields. Those preceding him, as well as those following, kept crying out, 'Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father David that is to come. Hosanna in the highest.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, like the crowds who acclaimed Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace with joy.
In the name of Christ, amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who is an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson and patient suffering, and so merit a share in his resurrection. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I may know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard, my face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help. Therefore, I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With parted lips, they wag their heads. relied on the Lord, let him deliver him. Let him rescue him if he loves him.
My God.
A pack of evildoers closes in upon me. They have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones.
My God.
My garments among them, and for my vesture they cast lots. But you, O Lord, be not far from me. O my help, hasten to aid me.
My
proclaim your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you descendants of Jacob, give glory to him. Revere him. All you descendants of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So the chief priests and the scribes.
The passion of the Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. The Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread were to take place in 2 days' time.
So the chief priests and the scribes were seeking a way to arrest him by treachery and put him to death. They said,
Not during the festival, for fear that they may be a riot among the people.
When he was in Bethany, reclining at table in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came with an alabaster jar of perfumed oil, costly, genuine spikenard. She broke the alabaster jar and poured it on his head. There were some who were indignant.
Why has there been this waste of perfume oil? It could have been sold for more than 300 days' wages and the money given to the poor.
They were infuriated with her. Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you make trouble for her? She has done a good thing for me. The poor you will always have with you, and whenever you wish, you can do good to them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anticipated anointing my body for burial. Amen, I say to you, whenever the gospel is proclaimed to the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, went off to the chief priests to hand him over to them. When they heard him, they were pleased and promised to pay him money. Then he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?
He sent two of his disciples and said to them,
"Go into the city, and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room? Where may I eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there."
The disciples then went off, entered the city, and found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and as they reclined at table and were eating, Jesus said,
"Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be distressed and to say to him, one by one,
"Surely it is not I."
He said to them,
"One of the 12, the one who dips with me into this dish. For the Son of Man indeed goes, as it is written of him. But woe to the man by whom the Son of God is betrayed. It would be better for that man if it had never been born."
While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, and said,
"Take this. This is my body."
Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them. And they all drank from it. He said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God."
Then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
"All of you will have your faith shaken. For it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will disperse.' But after I have been raised up, I shall go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Though all may have their faith shaken, mine will never be."
Jesus said to him,
"Amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times.
Peter said to him,
"Even though all shall have their faith shaken, mine will not be."
Then Jesus said to him,
"Amen, I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he vehemently replied,
"Even though I shall have to die with you, I will not deny you."
And they all spoke similarly. Then they came to a place named Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
He took with him Peter, James, and John, and began to be troubled and distressed. Then he said to them,
"My soul is sorrowful even to death. Remain here and keep watch."
He advanced a little and fell to the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass by him. He said,
"Abba, Father, all things are possible to you. Take this cup away from me, but not what I will, but what you will."
When he returned, he found them asleep. He said to Peter,
"Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not undergo the test. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak."
Withdrawing again, he prayed, saying the same thing. Then he returned once more and found them asleep, for they could not keep their eyes open and did not know what to answer him. He returned a third time and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. Behold, the Son of Man is to be handed over to sinners. Get up, let us go. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Then, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, accompanied by a crowd with swords and clubs, who had come from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. His betrayer had arranged a signal with them, saying,
"The man I shall kiss is the one. Arrest and lead him away securely."
He came and immediately went over to him and said,
"Rabbi."
And he kissed him. At this, they laid hands on him and arrested him. One of the bystanders drew his sword, struck the high priest's servant, and cut off his ear. Jesus said to them in reply,
"Have you come out us against a robber with swords and clubs to seize me? Day after day I was with you teaching in the temple area, yet you did not arrest me, but that the scriptures may be fulfilled."
And they all left him and fled. Now a young man followed him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth about his body. They seized him, but he left the cloth behind and ran off naked. They led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. Peter followed him at a distance into the high priest's courtyard and was seated with the guards, warming himself at the fire. The chief priests and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none. Many gave false witness against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and testified falsely against him, alleging,
We heard him say, I will destroy this temple made with hands,
and within 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.
Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest rose before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying,
"No answer. What are these men testifying against you?"
But he was silent and answered nothing. Again, the high priest asked him and said to him,
"Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Then Jesus answered,
"I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven."
At that, the high priest tore his garments and said,
"Have we of witnesses? You have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?"
They all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him and struck him and said to him,
Prophesy.
And the guards greeted him with blows. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the high priest's maids came along. Seeing Peter warming himself, she looked intently at him and said,
You too were the Nazarene Jesus.
But he denied it, saying,
I neither know nor understand what you are talking about.
So he went out into the outer court. Then the cock crowed. The maid saw him and began again to say to the bystanders,
"This man is one of them."
Once again, he denied it. A little later, the bystanders said to Peter once more,
"For you too are a Galilean."
He began to curse and to swear,
"I do not know this man about whom you are talking."
And immediately a cock crowed a second time. Then Peter remembered the word of Jesus had said to him, "Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times." He broke down and wept. And as morning came, the chief priests with the elders and the scribes, that is the whole Sanhedrin, held a council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate questioned him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He said to him in reply,
"You say so."
The chief priests accused him of many things. Again, Pilate questioned him,
"No answer? See how many things they accuse you of?"
Jesus gave him no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now, on the occasion of the feast, he used to release to them one prisoner whom they requested. A man called Barabbas was then in prison, along with the rebels who had committed murder in a rebellion. The crowd came forward and began to ask him to do for them as he was accustomed. Pilate answered,
"Do you want me to release you to the king of the Jews?"
For he knew that it was out of envy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate again said to them in reply,
"Then what do you want me to do with this man you call the king of the Jews?"
They shouted again,
"Crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
They only shouted the louder,
Crucify him.
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas to them, and after he had Jesus scourged, handed him over to be crucified. The soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is, the praetorium, and assembled the whole cohort. They clothed him in purple, and weaving a crown of thorns, placed it on him. They began to salute him with,
Hail, King of the Jews!
And kept striking his head with a reed and spitting upon him. They knelt before him in homage, and when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak, dressed him in his own clothes, and led him out to crucify him. They pressed into service a passerby by Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. They brought him to the place of Golgotha, which is translated place of the skull. They gave him wine drugged with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him and divided his garments by casting lots for them to see what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." With him, they crucified two revolutionaries, one on his right and one on his left. Those passing by reviled him, shaking their heads and saying,
You would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days. Save yourself by coming down from the cross.
Likewise, the chief priests with the scribes mocked him among themselves and said,
He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross that we may see and believe.
Those who were crucified with him also kept abusing him. At noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lima sabachthani,"
which is translated,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Some of the bystanders who heard it said,
Look, he is calling Elijah.
One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying,
"Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down.
Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was a son of God."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of the younger James and Joses, and Salome.
These women followed him when Galilee he was ministered to him. There were also many other women who had become up with him to Jerusalem.
Day of preparation, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a distinguished member of the council, who was himself awaiting the kingdom of God, came and courageously went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus.
Pilate was amazed that he was already dead. He summoned the centurion and asked him if Jesus had already died. And when he learned of it from the centurion, he gave the body to Joseph. Having bought a linen cloth, he took him down, wrapped him in the linen cloth, and laid him in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock.
Then he rolled a stone against the entrance of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, watch where he was laid. The Gospel of the Lord. Any more tickets? Tickets, no tickets. I'm just kidding. Good evening. How are we today? Today, as we begin, it is wonderful to see everyone here, and we're all here because it is the beginning of Holy Week. And we are only days away from the resurrection. So we have to say, God is good. All the time. Absolutely. So again, welcome those that have been gone for some time. If you are the first time here or you've been gone for some time, welcome. We are glad you are here. And I'd like to welcome those who are joining us on social media. Please continue to tune in and bring a friend. Again, I'd like to welcome everyone to Holy Week. Today we receive palm branches, the memory of Jesus' triumph entry into Jerusalem. Then we heard in the gospel reading the betrayal of Jesus, his humiliating of the public scorning, and then we will soon hear of the cross. In our first reading from the book of Isaiah, we hear the third song of the suffering servant of God. We hear how the servant was beaten and abused. The servant describes his faithful obedience, his willing acceptance of suffering, and his unwavering trust in God. Despite hardships, the servant remains confident, knowing that God helps and vindicates him. In our second reading from the letter of Philippians, Paul reminds us of humility and obedience of Christ, the servant of God. Humbly, the servant of God accepted all his suffering to save us. He offered and lost his life to secure victory for us. In our gospel reading from Mark, we hear of Jesus as the suffering servant who is the Son of God. We hear of the cross of Jesus, the way of glory, and the climax of his ministry. Jesus alone seems to understand his mission. The disciples are not shown in a good light, and their behavior at times is quite different, and especially at the time of his arrest. And the suffering of Jesus is troubling. In the end, Peter denied Jesus, Judas betrayed him, and Peter, James, and John fell asleep on him during his agony. Palms represent the royalty of Christ and his peaceful reign. Palm Sunday celebrates the triumphant return or entry of Christ into Jerusalem, the royal city. It was necessary for Christ to go to Jerusalem because he is truly both King of heaven and earth. So his entry into the royal city is highly symbolic to fulfill what the prophet Isaiah had long foretold. Holy Week is a great time for remembering how much Jesus loved us. We remember what he did on the night before he died. We remember his last request in the scriptures we hear. Love one another as I have loved you. We remember his words in the scriptures. Be not afraid, I am always with you. We remember our faults and our weaknesses, and in humility, we turn to him to forgive and to heal us. We remember that he left us a mission to accomplish. We are supposed to spread the good news, that is, that God is a God who loves us, and there is hope. Jesus had a mission when he came into the world. Jesus' mission was that he came to share himself in his fullness with all the people. He came to share himself with all those he preached to. It means that he continues to share himself with all of us every time we listen to and receive his living word. Living the word is a very way of life. Brothers and sisters, despite all that happened to Jesus, he never changed. He remained faithful to the mission entrusted to him. He willingly offered his whole life for our salvation. The road to kingdom of God is a narrow one. It tests our determination and following the footsteps of Jesus. Like Jesus, we must remain faithful to God at all times. We must learn to give of ourselves fully to the mission entrusted to us on this day, this Holy Week.
The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
Let us pray for the church, for ourselves, that our celebration of the Paschal Triduum may renew and expand the faith of all whom Jesus came to save. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the people of the Holy Land, that they may see their position as one of service, service to the people who elected them, service to the ideals of government, and service to the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our community, that we recognize Christ in the face of our sisters and brothers whom carry heavy crosses caused by hunger, climate change, and poverty, and that we help to alleviate these burdens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our donors, ministries, families, children, the elderly, and the unemployed, that the Lord will see to their every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the repose of the soul, Armando Elizar Amenquita. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. We also pray for our intentions and the intentions of the families celebrating this Mass online. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for vocations. Jesus, our Savior, your sacred heart felt compassion when you looked upon the crowd and saw that they were like sheep without a shepherd. We know that the harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So we ask you, the Master of the harvest, to send out more laborers. Open my heart and the hearts of my brothers and sisters to your will. Raise up joyful young men and women who are open to grow in holiness and devotion and spend themselves for your people in the Diocese of Austin as nuns, sisters, monks, brothers, friars, permanent deacons, and priests. May no one in your flock, won at the price of your blood, be without a shepherd to guide them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to now proceed to our offertory. We invite all of you to please come forward with an offering, either in your hands or in the heart. We would like everyone to participate and approach the altar of Jesus today. Father, we thank you for the many blessings that you give us. And as we approach your altar, see not only what is in our heart, hands, but also see what remains deep in the silence of our hearts. And please receive it through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Father, we thank you for the many blessings that you give us, especially for the blessing of Jesus, our Savior, who died and rose for us and for our salvation. Please accept these offerings that were brought with sacrifice and with humility by your Holy Church through Christ our Lord. Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Through the passion of your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Lift up. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, Jesus offered willingly for sinners in the accepted and just condemnation to save the guilty. Jesus' death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joe, our Bishop, and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
If you cannot receive Holy Communion today, please say this prayer with me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection you may lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord. Once a month, we pick up a collection that is destined to help the needs of the poorest members of our community. If you would like to contribute to their needs, please deposit an offering now. Thank you very much for your extra contributions for the needs of the poor. There are some of you that are visiting. If you are visiting, raise your hand, please. Some of you are visiting. No? No one is visiting? There is a couple here. There's some that are visiting. Can you please stand if you are visiting? Because we want to welcome you. No? Yes, there is one person there. That's great. Fabulous, fabulous. Thank you very much. God bless you. Come back and see us. As you know, we're going to be having a conference for women, for Catholic women, regarding the Eucharist on April 20th. The tickets are already up for sale, and if you want to get your ticket, you may just follow that QR code or contact the parish office, and they'll tell you how to get there. Tomorrow, the Movimiento Familiar Cristiano will be selling breakfast and outside sales. If you would like to contribute to their ministry, that will be great. And as you know, that area is closed for the building of a new baptismal font that we are going to be inaugurating probably this coming Saturday, a week from today. And so you cannot see, but it is coming along. It's coming very beautiful. I think you're going to be nicely impressed of how beautiful it will be. Just a friendly reminder, although it is in the bulletin, that the Easter Triduum begins on Thursday at 7 o'clock with the celebration of the Lord's Supper. Then it continues on Friday at 7 o'clock with the veneration of the Holy Cross. And on Saturday, there will be no Mass at 5 o'clock. Hear me out. No Mass at 5 o'clock. We will have it at 9 o'clock. And it is the only one Mass of the year which lasts about 4 hours. So you are welcome to attend, but please be aware that this is not a one-hour Mass, okay? It's a three or four-hour Mass, just so that you know. And finally, we would like to bless religious items. If you have candles or other things that you would like to have blessed, please stand with your things in your hands. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name, O Lord. You are the fount and source of every blessing. You look with delight upon the devout practices of your children. Draw near, we pray, on these your servants, and as they use these symbols of their faith and devotion, grant that they may also strive to be transformed into the likeness of Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Look, we pray, O Lord, on this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ did not hesitate to be delivered into the hands of the wicked, and submit to the agony of the cross.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. We'll see you on Thursday. sub tuum presidium confugimus, sancta Dei genitrix, nostras deprecationes, ne despicias in necessitatibus, sed a pericolis conctis, libera nos semper. Virgo benedicta. May the souls of our faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be ever a moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be ever a moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be ever a moment thine.